Good evening once more. I am sorry for the technical glitch which held all of us up. And now, without taking much time, I'll ask Neil Voraji to please share his thoughts on the topic and his team to share their brief presentation on this.
So first of all, I'd like to thank CPAI for this opportunity. India CDSL is deeply honored to be part of this group. I would like to welcome all the participants. Very, very good evening. I'm Nehal Vora, the MD and CEO of CDSL. So I'll just give some of the brief thoughts and opening remarks before I'll ask my team, Naina Ovlekar, who's a COO, Amit Mahajan, who's a CTO, Mr. Ram Kumar, who is the head CBO, or the head of business, and Yogesh Kunnani, who are both heading the business, to make a presentation. So in terms of the entire genesis of the margin pledge system, which SEBI is prescribed as a part of its circular, has in terms of, I think there is a lot of echo. In terms of the way SEBI has prescribed this entire system, is there's a paradigm shift which is happening from the existing transfer of securities, where earlier clients had to transfer the securities to the trading member or the clearing member before it could get pledged as margin. Now the shares will remain within the client's account or the BO's account, and there will be a flag which has been put in case if it's pledged from the trading member onto that client securities. And in case if the trading member then in turn repledges it to the clearing member, it will again get another flag. And in turn, if the clearing member pledges to the clearing corporation, there'll be another flag. So basically the customer or the investor or the beneficial owner, whatever name you may call, will have complete visibility on the extent the shares have been pledged or repledged, and with whoever it has been pledged or repledged. In case of an invocation, it will be a seamless technological transfer in terms of it getting invoked. And similarly, the release of pledge also will be through the technological system to make it a very seamless user experience. To ensure that there is a proper authorization, there will be a OTP sent directly by the depositories to the client who will have to input it into the depository system before such shares are pledged in favor of the trading member or the clearing member. So with this brief background, the entire intent is to make the system safer. The entire intent is to bring in transparency, objectivity into the way of functioning, and to ensure that the authorization between the investor stroke beneficial owner directly with the depository. So with these opening remarks, I would request my colleague Naina, who is the Chief Operating Officer, to give a brief presentation on the system. Over to you, Naina.
Thank you. And thank you, CPAI, for organizing this webinar, which will surely help to address various doubts that are there in the minds of brokers as well as clients regarding this margin pledge and repledge system. So I'll start the presentation. What I'll do is that because there has been some issues with the time spent already, I will make it a short presentation. I will not repeat whatever has already been said by NSDL and which is of general nature. And we will try to cover various features of this process, which is, and look at it from the client perspective. So just, I'll go to the next slide. Okay. So as this has been already covered and we are all aware that there will be a parallel run of margin pledge and existing system of title transfer to collateral till 31st August. The only thing that we need to understand is that by 31st August 2020, all existing DMAT accounts which are tagged as client collateral account or PMCM collateral account, they have to be closed. Similarly, client margin trading securities account, which was being used to hold funded stocks, that account also needs to be closed. So these two types of accounts have to be closed by 31st August. And my sincere request to all of you is that because we have already enabled opening of these accounts, alternative accounts for margin pledge, as well as client securities margin funding account, take this opportunity and open those accounts and start using this system till the time we also have the leeway of going back to the old system, so that if there are any problems or issues faced or in understanding the system or in educating the clients, we will come to know beforehand till and avoid the problem when it goes live on by 31st August 2020, wherein we don't have the luxury of going back to the old system. So the timeline for the closure of collateral accounts remains as 31st August, and the margin trading funding account also has to be opened and be operational by 31st August. Some other key points related to margin pledge are that there will not be any inter-depository pledge which will be allowed. So currently also in the normal pledge transaction, inter-depository pledge is not allowed. Same thing will happen for margin pledge also. In the normal pledge transaction, you are all aware that auto pledge acceptance facility is available. So if a client has given a pledge instruction and you are a pledgee, and if you have enabled this auto pledge acceptance facility, then you don't have to give another instruction to your DP to accept such pledge. Same facility has been made available even in case of margin pledge, wherein if you enable this facility, then for accepting margin pledge, you don't have to give a separate instruction to the DP, and it will be a seamless experience for you. Similarly, in the existing pledge mechanism, which is already there, it will continue as it is. Margin pledge will be a separate type of pledge instruction, and it will be identified in the depository system as the margin pledge. So the pledge for the purpose of funded stock, okay, which has been specified in the SEBI circular, that will happen through normal pledge mechanism. It will not be through margin pledge. The only difference will be that for such a pledge, which is for the funded stock, and it which will be in favor of the client securities margin funding account, the OTP authentication by the pledger will be mandatory. So that will be the difference. So there are two separate streams. One is margin pledge and the other one is the pledge mechanism, the normal pledge mechanism. So as a trading and clearing member, what is it that you need to do? So first and foremost, you have to open DMAT accounts. So just a little bit of clarification on what are the different types of accounts which can be opened. So if you are a trading member who has appointed professional clearing members for all the segments in which you trade, then you will open a PM client securities margin pledge account. If you are a clearing member, that is you are a professional clearing member, or you are a trading member who is a self-clearing member for all the segments, then you can open a CM client securities margin pledge account. But if you are a TM who has appointed professional clearing member for some segments and who happens to be a self-clearing member for remaining segments, then you can open a TMCM client securities margin pledge account. So this particular TMCM client securities margin pledge account can be used for acceptance of pledge as well as for repledging in favor of clearing corporation. Similarly, we have also enabled opening of the margin funding account, and there is a separate substatus for it. So you can open that account, which will act as a pledgee account, and funded stocks will have to be pledged in favor of that account. Now for opening margin pledge account, we have made it very friendly for clearing members and trading members. So if you are already having your pool account with existing DP and you want to open the new account with the existing DP only, then you just have to submit a consent form. and a board resolution, and your account can get opened. Of course, if you are going to a new DP for opening a margin pledge account, then you will have to submit all the account opening forms, documents, etc. Now, one thing which is being asked by many people is that can we change existing accounts status, substatus to make them a margin pledge account? So no, that is not available. You will have to open a fresh account only for accepting the margin pledges. So that is in brief what you have to do for opening the accounts. Now let us see what the client does and how the client will initiate the margin pledge. So the submission of margin pledge instruction, that will happen by the client either in physical mode, that is by giving the margin pledge request form. If he has given a power of attorney, then the power of attorney holder will give that instruction to the DP of the client. The client also have an option to use internet-based facility, which is provided by the by CDSL. We call it as easiest. So if you are an easiest registered beneficial owner or a client, then you can go to this system and initiate a margin pledge, which will directly come to the depository. Now, if you are submitting instructions to your DP, that is depository participant, then after the entry of that particular instruction by the DP in CDSL, what CDSL is going to do is that CDSL will send an authorization link to the mobile number and the email ID of the client, which is registered in the DMAT account. That authorization link will be available, and the BO just has to click on that link, and then the CDSL web page will get opened. On that web page, the client will have to enter either his DMAT account number or the PAN. Once he enters that, the CDSL web page will show the details of all margin pledges which are pending for authorization of the client. Now the client can look at those margin pledges, select all those pledges which are pending for authorization, or select a specific pledge request. The option is available for the client. So he has to select those pledges which he wants to authorize and then generate the OTP. Once the OTP is received by him, the OTP will have to be entered on the CDSL webpage for authorizing transaction. Only after this OTP is entered, the transaction will be accepted by CDSL for further processing. Now let us see some features which are there for this OTP generation as well as the authorization. So CDSL has provided for future dated margin pledge instruction. Now what does that mean? That will mean that the client can enter a margin pledge instruction with an execution date which is in future. So when he is entering the transaction, that he may not have the holdings also, but on the execution date of the margin pledge transaction, he needs to have the holding. Similarly, the authorization link which will be sent as soon as the margin pledge transaction is set up. So the authorization, sending of authorization link will not be kept on hold till the execution date. So suppose today you are entering, or your client is entering the margin pledge transaction, which is to be executed say on Monday, then the authorization link will be sent to the client on before today's EOD itself. So once the authorization link is sent to the client, that authorization link will be valid till the client actually authenticates the transaction through OTP, or it will be valid till the end of day of the execution date, whichever is earlier. So if he authenticates the transaction on the same day, the authorization link after that will become irrelevant, or that link will remain valid till the EOD of the execution. Now, OTP validation Or how long will be the OTP valid? OTP will be valid for 15 minutes. So once the client goes on the CDSL webpage, selects the pledges and then generates the OTP. After that, the OTP will be valid for 15 minutes. All non-authenticated transactions will get cancelled at the EOD of the execution date. And OTP authentication again will be allowed from the setup date till the EOD of the execution date. Now, sometimes a question is being asked that what happens if the authorization link is not received by the client? Then what do we do? So we have provided one option on CDSL website where the client can go, enter the BOID and the PAN, and then he will be shown the pending margin pledge transactions which are pending for authorization. It's the same web page which will be shown when he clicks on the authorization link. So he will get option to select the transactions for authentication and then he can go and generate OTP. This is one alternative which has been given by CDSL and that can be used by your clients. Similarly, there needs to be an express consent given by the client for repledge of securities by TM or CM. That is the mandate of SEBI circular. So in addition of entering such kind of consent in the margin pledge request form, which we have devised for physical form, suppose the client is entering the OTP or entering the transaction electronically on CDSL's web-based portal, that is EGS, then again the client will give this electronic consent. Then client will have to mention UCC, TMID, CMID and the segment while giving the margin pledge transaction. With respect to segment, there is an option to mention a specific segment or the client can choose to mention all segments. If the client mentions a specific segment, then the TM or CM when he is repledging, he has to enter only that specific segment and allow the repledge for that specific segment only. But in case the client gives the segment as all, then the TM and CM while repledging can choose the segment of their own choice. The client will have visibility on margin pledge and replace transactions. So a client will come to know as to which are those margin pledges which he has created, which are those pledges which have been replaced by the trading member or the clearing member, and what is the status of that replace. So that complete visibility will be available to the client. And similarly, the visibility of replace transactions will be available to the trading member as well as the clearing member. So that link will be maintained by the CDSL system. I will not get into details of this because you people will be already knowing about it. But one important thing that I need to emphasize is that in CDSL system, if you want to do a partial replace, then that facility is available. And similarly, partial release or partial invocation, that facility is also available in CDSL system. So taking an example, if a client has done a margin pledge for say 10,000 securities, then against that margin pledge, the trading member can choose to repledge only 5,000 securities in favor of the clearing member. Clearing member in turn later on can release out of that 5,000, 3,000 securities back to the trading member. So that facility is currently being offered by CDSL. And we all are aware that the client authentication through OTP is actually not required for repledge transactions. One more thing which has to be kept in mind is that the CM account, which is being used for margin pledge, it has to be registered with the CC before CC can accept the replace transactions, from that particular account. So that has to be kept in mind, and appropriate instructions will have to be given to CC to register that particular account. Then coming to release or invocation of margin pledge, as I mentioned, the partial release or partial invocation is available. In case of release or invocation, whichever are the upper entities in the chain of repledge, they need to release the pledge, the subsequent repledges. So in case of invocation of a margin pledge by a TM, and if that margin pledge has been repledged with CC through a clearing member, then the CC will have to release it to CM, and then the CM will have to release it to TM. Only then the invocation of margin pledge will get executed. The entry of these transactions can take place in any sequence, but for the execution of invocation, the releases by the upper entities in the chain of repledge will have to be done. So this is in short our presentation, and thank you everyone for giving this opportunity to us. Thank you.
Thank you, Naina Madam, for your brief but very insightful presentation. Can I ask Vikram Kothari ji to please say a few words upon how NSCCL is planning to implement this change, and maybe his team can enlighten us.
Thank you, Virinder ji. Thanks for having us over. So briefly, I think it's a new era where we are looking at an entire overall of the
collateral. Before you start, I thought let me ask one or two questions from the depositories.
Please, Ashok ji.
Yeah. So, in case of release or invocation, can we do a partial release oblique partial invocation? Yeah. This is for Mr. Nageswar Rao or Mr. Bora.
Yeah, so in the case of NSDL system, the partial release is not yet available. We are working on it because we will be launching it shortly.
Yeah, because release will have to be partial most of the times.
So in case... In a case of CDSL, as Naina has highlighted in our presentation, the partial release and invocation is possible in the CDSL system.
Mr. Kothari, you can proceed. Yeah, please.
Thank you, Ashok.
Yeah.
Thank you very much. So thank you very much for having us over. In fact, just wanted to briefly say that yes, it's a big change from the way we have seen the industry provide collaterals in the past. It's a new era, I think. So from a clearing corporation perspective, from a system development perspective, we are ready to manage the transactions. I think as we move forward, we all know that there's an extended period of 1 month available where members, I would request the members to start, not wait. And as Nageswar Rao Saab had also said in the past, not wait till the last. I think we should try and start doing our transactions as fast as possible. On the process, we are trying to keep the process seamless. We will have information go out to the members with respect to the utilizations. One of the major concerns that the members had expressed is that today when they actually provide securities as collateral, it is available the moment, and it is available at the clearing member level, and typically clearing member has passed on the benefit over to the trading member or the clients the moment he's actually received it in his account. And when this process is actually going to happen, where it's going to come through pledge process, how seamless or how time taking it is going to be for a clearing member to get the benefit, or when the trade of a client comes in and the utilization to shift to the client collateral. So we have tried to ensure that it remains seamless so that the clearing members on their collaterals do not see a big time lag in their utilization shifting over to the client's available collateral. We are still testing out, enough data is still not there for us to check volumes, but our intention and our try is that we will keep it limited to not more than a couple of seconds of lag. That's the intention to actually achieve, where we'll try to keep it to a couple of seconds or maybe 5 to 6 seconds as far as possible to have that transaction compute the utilizations at a client level and give the benefit to the clearing member level. I will not take a lot of time because I'm sure we would like to keep time for question answers. You're already late on the session. So I would like to hand it over to Josef. Unfortunately, he's not able to join through his own PC. So he's just joined me in the room and I'm going to hand over the laptop to him for him to make the presentation. Thank you.
Hello. Yeah. Good evening, everyone. So we'll just run through the process of what clearing corporation will be handling it. So I think the earlier part of what accounts to be open and that has been already covered by the depository. So we'll just skip on that part. And like currently, what we'll be doing is that on a regular interval, we'll be receiving the pledge information. So whatever pledge has been marked, re-pledge has been marked in the favor of clearing corporation, we'll be getting those information from the depositories. The information will include the UCC TM code and the clearing member code and the segment for which the pledge has been marked. And accordingly, these collaterals will be considered in those segments. So coming directly to on how we will be valuing those collaterals, so there'll be no change which is happening in the valuation methodology which we have been doing for securities as collateral. So the existing requirement for a 50-50 ratio at a clearing member level, market-wide limits, trading member-wise limits, and value-wise limits which are currently present will continue. So the quantum of securities which a clearing member can give, either through a way of his own securities or as a repledge of the client securities, will continue to what quantum is there today. The only difference could be securities, client securities which are repledged will be identified separately and can be used only towards margin requirement for such clients. And other difference would be that in case of a trading member, if the trading member gives his own proprietary shares, such shares can be used for his own proprietary trading plus all clients clearing through such trading member. Similarly, if the clearing member gives his own securities, such securities can be used for using margins for all clients and all trading members clearing through such clearing members. So otherwise the valuation methodology, so we'll be providing a detailed client-wise reports on the values of securities which we are considered, even security-wise, ISN-wise securities for which valuation has been considered and for which valuation has not been considered. The second important change which will be in terms of the monitoring which we'll be doing. So whenever the first trade happens, the margin will continue to be blocked from the TM limits and the clearing members collateral like it has been done today. But subsequently what we'll do is that on as close to possible real time, we will try and see if for that client for which the trade has happened, whether any client securities are available with the clearing corporation. If such securities are available, so in this example, on step one, when the margin requirements of 80 comes in, the margin will be first blocked from the TM limit and the clearing members collateral. In the second step, we will go and check whether the client has any securities. Since this client has provided a securities of 100, the margin will be blocked from the client securities and equivalent credit will be given to the TM and the CM. So that much margin reduction will happen of the CM and the TM. And this process we'll keep on doing after every change in margin, which can happen due to a trade or due to a change in the margins. And whatever debit credit happens will keep on happening as close as real time is possible. Similarly, if the margins of the clients are exhausted and there are margin available of that at a trading member level, securities available at trading member level, then the margin will start getting blocked from the trading member's collateral. And if both client as well as TM securities are utilized, then it will continue to get blocked from the clearing member's collateral and the TM limit. So this will be the major change which will happen at the clearing corporation level. Third major change which we are going to happen is in the way the request for collateral happens. So currently, clearing members simply request for a security to be released and it is the quantity is requested and is just released. But now, since the client securities have been maintained at a client member level, while requesting for release, the members will have to specify for which client and which for which TM the request is required so that they can accordingly pass on to those specific date. Then based on those information, clearing corporation will release the client specific securities pledge which have been marked. Now there can be instances where though client have requested for release or the member has requested for release, there are some margins which are already been utilized from such client collaterals. So in this case, what we'll check the, if the clearing member has sufficient free collateral, we will still go ahead and release the client collateral and the margin requirement for such client margins will be blocked from the clearing member's collateral so that the client securities can still be released. And this release, like I think depositories have already confirmed, that does not result in a direct release to end client. This only releases the first level or the last created in favor of clearing corporation. And the members will have to then further release it to and subsequently. In terms of information, we will be providing end of day client-wise breakup of the collaterals. So client-wise, ISIN-wise quantity which has been available with clearing corporation and what has been considered for valuation, what has not been considered for valuation. In a real-time basis also on our NMAS screens, people will be able to see what is the current valuation for client securities at a UCC level is which has been provided and how much credit or how much margins have been blocked from such securities and how much credit has been provided to the clearing and the trading member. So these are the additional informations also which will be provided to the members. So these are the major changes which will be happening. So we will be implementing this from 1st August. All securities which comes through pledge replay from 1st August will be visible in this reports and this screen. And the existing securities which are there as on now pledge, plus if they come through the existing module during the month, will be handled as been done currently by adding directly to the clearing members collateral. So this is from our side.
Thank you, Ji. So can I ask Sony Ji from NSE to share his thoughts and thereafter we'll have the Q&A session.
Yes, good evening, everyone. So I think finally we could come to this place, Zoom. Initially, there were some hiccups. So thank you very much, Commodity Participant Association of India, for giving us this opportunity. It is indeed a pleasure to be amongst the member, and these little testing times we have in terms of, like Nehal also mentioned, there's a landscape change which has happened in the securities market. So just to give a background, because last 4 or 5 years there has been significant changes, regulatory changes which have come up in our market, starting off from risk-based supervision in 2015, then 2016 we had enhanced supervision, 2019 we had pledging banned to the outside entities in terms of raising funds. So when you just go to the background, every things which has been put in place has resulted into cleaning up of the markets. So the major impact has been, I would say personally, I would believe the major thing which has resulted into many of the cases which have come to light in 1920 has been because of the reporting which started off in January 2019. So, you know, which resulted in brokers to give us weekly information. And previously, we used to have our supervision process once in a year or, you know, sometimes even once in 3 years also, wherein we would do something on based on sample basis. So I would, you know, like to like that associations and members know that now, you know, because everybody is interested in kind of we having a cleaner market. So we are now in a position to more or less check obligations of nearly all the clients with the support of depositories and clearing corporation. So there are certain system enhancements which have come over, which has overall resulted into, betterment of all. And one good thing, even in these testing times, we have seen overall a lot of interest in the equity markets, new millennials opening new account. And this has in a way, new demat accounts being open, trading account being open. So this is, I think, a very positive feature for entire ecosystem. So now regulator has, you know, brought in this new thing, which is obviously in the interest of all the stakeholders, because more safer the market, it is expected to attract a lot of interest. Still, our participation as compared to other developed market participation of a common citizen is far less than I think what is there. So while yes, there are certain operational hiccups, and I think regulator has been kind enough to grant us some extension during this period, wherein two parallel systems will run. Depositories and clearing corporation have also, I think there have been number of sessions where all of us have tried to, you know, clear the operational difficulties. Now all systems are also ready. So this should go a long way in addressing the concerns and making the market safer. And it would be, I think, in the interest of all, to positively contribute to it, so that in the month of August only we are, we are in a position to switch over. And as September comes, the old accounts are closed, and perhaps, you know, we would start a new era in terms of investor protection. So these are only my words. So we have, with regard to this specific pledge repledge, we have shared the FAQs. I think a lot of things which were unclear also yesterday, also there was a SEBI circular, so which has, you know, set the context also. I think there is a very kind of, in terms of two system running parallelly, that would be a lot of ease of business to the market. And there is a hand holding, which I think all the MIIs will definitely do work together. So we also seek support of and all the associations and also the broker members. So with these words, I will just close my remarks. We don't have a particular presentation, but because I know you would be having a lot of questions, so we would be glad to answer your questions. Thank you.
So, sir, before we start, I hand over to Ajay ji for the question and answer. There's one question which has come up multiple times from the audience, so I'd like you to address it first upfront if it is possible. So the question is, would the shares lying in the DMAT account where the client has already given POA to the trading member be considered as margin collected from the client till 31st August or not?
So the answer, direct answer to that is no. Only to the extent of those stocks which are blocked already as on 31st July, or the stocks which are in the collateral account. Any incremental thing for which a position has to be allowed, only that has to come through pledge and repledge mechanism. So whatever has been, suppose a client has 10 ISIN, out of that certain ISINs have been already blocked and there is a position, to that extent it will be allowed. Fresh incremental thing will not be allowed.
Okay, sir. So I'll ask Ajay ji to please now start his Q&A, because I think most of the doubts will get clarified by the illustrations and the questions which he has. Ajay ji, please.
Yeah, good evening, everyone. So CPI is great to have such a distinguished panel. We do have clearing corporation, we do have depositories.
Ajay ji, your voice is echoing. Can you please check your mic?
Your mic is okay. Only one station is running. Now it is okay.
There is a lot of whistling coming from the background.
Now it is okay?
No.
No. Maybe if you have a headphone nearby, you could use a headphone or something. So we have had a lot of technical difficulties today. I apologize once more. Ajay ji, aap start kijiye. Koi baat nahi. Koi baat nahi.
I think you start. Yeah. Some noise we can tolerate.
Yes.
So we do have a lot of queries from all of our members, and the queries are related to clearing corporation, depositories, and the exchange compliance. Also, we have categorized the queries into majorly three parts. Yeah, so you start with clearing corporation queries. So the first question is, like, if the trading member is doing proprietary as well as client trading, whether the trading member can directly pledge own proprietary shares in favor of clearing member from his beneficiary account to CM's client security margin pledge account, or TM has to first pledge securities to TM's client security margin pledge account, and from there he has to pledge to CM's client security margin pledge account.
Maybe I can answer this question. So that you know, so in the NSDL system, the trading member can you know, have his BO account where he holds his proprietary shares, you know, so, and they can be directly pledged in favor of the CM's account, CM's client securities margin pledge.
Okay, it can be pledged directly to CM's margin security pledge account.
Yes.
Second question is, like, how frequently during the day will CC allocate the margin requirement at the client level to enable the release of exposure at CM and PM level?
Sir, so that as we informed in the presentation, we are trying to do it as quickly as possible. So as soon as the within a few seconds is what we will try and check. So the moment that margin gets changed, it will be checked, and within few seconds, if the collaterals are available, the credit will be given.
Okay, so it would be near real time basis. Hello.
Yes, Ajay. Yeah.
Now the third query is, the currently security pledged by the customer can be seamlessly used across all the segments, like whether it is equity derivative or currency derivatives. So under the new regime, if the client pledges the share for all the segments, can CM and TM pledge the same to clearing corporation for all the segments, so that client level margin fungibility to be maintained by clearing corporation on real time basis? Otherwise, the working capital of clearing member and trading member would be blocked.
Sir, so to start with, the clearing member will have to specify the segment where he is pledging, and in case he wants to shift it out, he will have to ask for release and put it in a new pledge in the new segment, like it has been done currently. But we are parallelly working on providing a transfer facility like we do for other type of collaterals. So intraday, then clearing member can request for transfer from one segment to another. But it is work in progress, and we will come back with a timeline on that separately, sir.
It would surely block margin at TM and CM level. So this fungibility is very important. It should be.
Yeah, Mr. Udepa, I think this should be done at the earliest.
Yes, sir. We are working on that, and we will try and do it as early as possible, sir.
This is going to be very critical, fungibility of in the segment.
Both queries: what would be the timeline for clearing corporation or unpledging of security if the request made by the clearing member? Whether the benefit of pledged securities will be provided to clearing member at the end of day basis? If request made for unpledged by clearing member with execution date of next day. So we have put an example as well. The client has sold 200 shares of Reliance on T day, which is pledged with clearing corporation. Now the CM has raised the request on T plus one day. to be unplaced on T plus 2 day. So the execution date would be T plus 2 days. So whether benefit of 200 share will be provided to clearing member on T plus 1 day, end of the day deposit report, and whether shares will be unplaced much before paying time on T plus 2 day, as clearing member has to release shares to the trading member, and then trading member has to release shares to the client, and then client has to the client share has to be transferred to pool account of the trading member for the paying, and the time is very short. So what the suggestion came that this process would become very cumbersome if some sort of automation can be built in, so that all the transactions should happen automatically.
So from clearing corporation side, sir, the members have that freedom to decide whether they want an immediate release or a value date release. In case they select a value date release, then suppose if the value date is say 4th of August, then on 3rd of August, end of day, the securities will be released, and it will be the pledge instruction, release instruction will be given to depository at end of day on 3rd of August. So members can always put a release request for a futuristic date and keep, and then it will be processed accordingly. The further part of automation, I think from the pledge to pain, we will have to check with the depository, sir.
I can answer that question as to how the released shares can be used for pay-in in a similar manner of putting in a future dated transaction for the pledge release. You can also put a future dated transaction for pay-in. Therefore, so as soon as the pledge shares are released, automatically they will go into the pay-in. In fact, you can even put in a current day transaction for paying as well. It will just go into overdue, and as soon as the shares are released from pledge, it will be processed for paying.
So, Josefa, technically, when we request for release, we'll be releasing at the end of today, or you'll be releasing tomorrow morning. This is the basic question.
Sir, it is end of today. So what we do is that if the value date is say 4th of August, then on 3rd of August, after end of day margins are computed, we check whether they are free, and then on 3rd August itself, we send the release instruction to depository. Maybe it may be in the evenings, but yeah, by end of the day processing, it gets the pledge gets released from the system at the depository end, sir. Of the clearing corporation, pledge will get released, sir.
Okay, so what a member can do is take a release from you, but since it is in his account, he can continue to count towards margin compliance of the customer and then release it in a future date so that it can move in time for paying, as depository is already enabled those functionalities.
Yes, sir.
Ajay ji, please continue.
No, sorry to interrupt. Can you further clarify that whether if you are taking the effect end of day, whether the stock's valuation will be considered for the collection of margin and reporting on that day or not? Mr. Hujaifa, please.
Clearing corporation anyway, we will be checking at end of the day if there is so like I said, when we are checking for release, we check that if there are the collaterals, the securities are free. If the client margins are blocked, then we try and see whether if we can block the margins from the clearing member collateral and then release the client securities. So if that what it will be released, sir. So the margin will be either blocked from the other collateral of the client or from the collateral of the clearing member, and the requested securities will get released, sir.
So that means we won't be like we won't be reporting that valuation on that day.
After we've released it, the securities are still with you as a clearing member, right? So it is available, it is still pledge marked to you. So I think as Virender ji had just said earlier, while we may release it to you in the night, the collaterals are still available to you as a pledge mark security, right?
Got it. Thank you.
Yes, Ajay ji, please.
Next question is the BTSD is still unsolved. Like, because in current scenario, if it is an FNO position, If you create a position and square it off next day, the margin is released. But in case of cash segment, like if customer has bought today and he has made the margin payment of say 60%, and next day is squaring off, then again 60% margin would be levied and it would become 120% margin. So this point again has to be looked into. The only one-sided margin on the purchase is with what members feel is sufficient. The second lack of margin should be removed.
Ajay, I know the question is posted under clearing corporations, but ideally the clearing corporation is doing cash market settlements on a rolling. We do not account for BTST. BTST is more of a treatment at a broker's end. So maybe if you may want to address this question or query, exchange compliance on how to treat this, but in my view, this may not be a clearing corporation.
Dinesh Soni is also here. You can address this issue. Okay. That would be better.
Yeah. For the BTST trades, that is, I don't know why in the question it is coming as in F&O segment, margin is levied. So, okay, so they have tried to compare, means the question tries to compare on the consolidated obligation vis-a-vis margin on BTST trade. So, we are trying to work on this. As of now, we know there is a problem in terms of dual margin, which is there, like it has been mentioned in this example. So, we are trying to find a solution in consultation with other MIIs and SEBI. Let's see in case we can find. As of now, yes, we know it is a challenge, but we are working, and let's see in case we can find out something.
Okay, thank you. Sixth point is like in current scenario, wherever the delay happens in security paying from it might be clearing corporation or depository end. Trading member and claim member margins kept on hold till completion of the pay-in by clearing corporation. Whereas trading member and claiming member margin should be released on the basis of early pay-in made by TM and clearing member till normal pay-in time. So wherever there is a delay, it would become a bit problematic for trading member and clearing member. Their margins would be hold. So if we can adjust the EPI, then in the morning it would be a breather.
But this is the problem which many days we are facing nowadays. If it can be helped, it will be a great help.
Huzaifa?
Sir, I could not. Can you repeat the question, sir?
Okay, I'll just tell you what the query is. The query is, if there is a delay in the depository system, the pain or the margin on the settlement till it is the pain is completed is blocked. And supposing the pain happens at 2 p.m., the margin is blocked till 2 p.m. So yes, is it possible that after the pain time, the current settlement exposure is dropped? Or if that cannot be done, at least whatever has been paid in by the members who have paid in, that sell leg obligation margin should be dropped. Currently, you do not process for on T plus 2 day any margin obligation of T day. But if the pain gets delayed, that margin remains blocked till the pain is completed.
So generally what happens is the intimation of as to how much pain has actually happened comes only when we get the pain files from the depositories. But we will definitely look into this, how it can be done best. But today the process is that the pain comes as a single pain instruction or information from the depositories. And that's when we do a release of margins for all members parallelly together, sir.
I understand, Huzaifa, but on T plus 1 day also, you get information during the day in batches of what pain has been done. And once that irreversible DCC has matched, you are allowing for that margin to be dropped. So if for some reason, operational reason, the pain is delayed, in a similar fashion, even on T plus 2 day, you can do the same.
Yeah. So we will have to check on that. We will check on that and revert, sir.
Sure. Please examine the possibilities.
Sir, this is important as the margin blocked amounts are substantial and it blocks a big amount wherever there are, the delay happens. It is a humble request from all the members.
Now, there are certain queries related to depositories. So both the depositories can answer. So how does the confirmation mechanism with link and OTP of pledge repledge work when the client does not have a smartphone and client is not a computer savvy?
So at least from CDSL's end, since these are more of the operational queries, I'll request my colleague Nena to reply to these. Thank you.
So for this confirmation mechanism, see, the DINC is being sent not only on the mobile, it is also being sent on the email ID. And we expect that the client will either use a mobile phone and access the link, or he will use email ID and access the link. So that is the option which the client has, and he needs to access that and then generate OTP and then enter the OTP.
70-80% of the clients might be computer savvy, but there are 50% of the clients, they might not be computer savvy. They might not have access to internet at that point of time.
The confirmation has to take place through OTP. So, and the OTP, as of now, this is the system that is being made available.
Again, request to look into any alternate mechanism can be built.
So through the CDSL website also, the person can log in, as Nena had mentioned in her presentation. So I think in today's times when all the trading is through an electronic medium, this is a process. I think most of us are, it is kind of a given that most of us will have a computer or an internet connection. Because that's a process of the authorization. The other alternative is that the customer can come over to the DP's end and use the terminal at the DP's end to put in the OTP.
Because once it is implemented, then I think the actual issue would keep on coming. But we, our member foresee this is going to be an issue for certain category of clients. Now the second query is that client initiate the pledge request and link is not delivered to the client due to whatsoever reason. There might be some glitch into the system. There might be some domain problem. There might be some problem into ISP. So how will he approve or verify the transaction? So I think if the link is there on depository and he can do that, I think this question will be resolved.
Is the link part is being confirmed by the NSDL also? CDSL is confirmed. Is it available? The client can go to the NSDL site and approve there?
No, it is not on the site because it's a specified, it's a personalized link which is sent to the email of the customer.
Yeah, suppose by any chance he does not receive, so the alternative mechanism.
We can have a recent option, but we can think about building this. No, in fact, actually, when you say NSDL site, because it's available as part of the NSDL IDSPD offering, right? Because therefore, if a person can confirm the pledge through his Speedy.
But Mr. Rao, Speedy is generally not given to the POA clients. This is also one of the questions. Because for the proper risk management, generally the brokers are giving online limits to the client on the trading system. So they generally don't allow Speedy to the clients from whom we do have a POA or even the EDS, the same similar thing would come. So then it would be an issue.
Yeah, but that is no longer relevant because now you cannot block the shares based on the POA. So therefore, it will have to be necessarily through the margin pledge.
That is right, but the way CDSL has given the option, so NSDL can also develop the similar option.
We can look at that. We can look at that as to how to do that safely. We have to ensure, so that we can look at it.
Thank you.
a related question to both the depositories is, are both the depositories going to publish some API through which electronically we can initiate a request for pledge which gets delivered to the customer? Will the member be able to generate any such kind of a request if he has a POA?
No, right now, Kusa, there is no API, but there is a file upload functionality. But we can build an API, Kusa, if there is a need.
So in CDSL, the clearing members can, those who are having the login onto the CDSL's EGS system, they can upload the file and get the pledge created, margin pledge created. So that facility will be available through internet if they are holding POA in their favor.
No, ma'am, you said this is for clearing member.
Yeah, so the clearing members also have login facility on EGS, that is our internet-based portal, through which they can upload transactions for their clients who have given POA in their favor.
Would that mean that that this facility is not available for trading members?
It should be available for TM and CM both. I think it must be available.
For them. It is available for those who are having the pool accounts. For them, it is available.
Correct.
Third query, again in line of automation, this client for the client that TM and CM has got a power dummy for the EDIS, then can we automate the process by a single request, the unpledging of shares and transfer to the pool accounts happens with a single instruction. Currently, two separate batch has to go. Can we automate it?
No, we discussed this, so that the way to address this is to put a future dated instruction for unpledge as well as for pay-in, because the unpledge actually happens at three levels, because depending upon where the securities are actually currently pledged. So unpledged will have to happen by CC, by then thereafter by CM, by TM, and then only it will go to the client account. And therefore, and similarly, so whether those shares are to be used for pay-in or not, so you know that is again a decision. Therefore, so that these instructions can be put in as a future data instruction. They will all get executed at the same time.
Agree with Mr.
Nagesh. Mr. Rao, but for future dated transactions, you are like releasing those stocks 1 day before, like at the EOD of T minus 1 day. So that would give big impact to the liquidity of the broker.
No, future date is you can put whatever date you like. I don't understand. So that if you want to do that only on a pay-in date, because you can do so.
But if the transfer to pool instruction would go into undo the,
If my pay-in is in the morning 10:30, so I have to give the future date transactions 1 day before the pay-in. Is it right?
On the pay-in date.
Okay.
If the instruction date is pay-in date.
Sir, is it possible to identify the unpledging related to the pay-in transaction separately, so they don't get mixed up and they get processed in a manner so that it is available for the pay-in? Well, in the sense, so that there the time sensitivity is very high. There can be normal unpledging, but there can be unpledging for the purpose of pay-in. We are saying, can we identify and unpledge in a timely manner for the pay-in?
No. So unpledge is the instruction given by the pledgee, right? So therefore, as soon as the pledgee gives the instruction, all instructions in the depository system instantaneously get executed. And if it is a future dated instruction, on the beginning of the day, so it will get executed.
If the transfer from BO to pool is there, it would go into overdue if the stock is not there. You to say that.
That is right.
So we will need future dated paying instruction also from the on behalf of the client.
Yes.
So that both can match.
Yes.
Release and the paying can match.
Yes.
Now, currently there are two, there are only two mechanisms for client to pledge securities towards margin. First, using a physical instruction, which is not feasible due to COVID-19 related issues. The second method using easiest and speedy. So EDS based system for pledging and re-pledging are not currently readily available with the depositories. The concern is that the client who have provided the POA or EDS are generally not enabled by TM for speedy and easiest. So this would create a problem for the clients who does not have the POA, the non-POA clients. So what are the timelines for OTP-based e-pledging through EDIS?
We have a DMAT gateway, which we call as a DMAT gateway available to clients who do not have POA issued to their brokers. On this platform, we will enable a margin pledge as well.
So what are the timelines that we want to understand?
No, before August 31st, it will be released.
And for CDSL?
Before 31st August?
Yeah. At the earliest, I'm just saying that it should be available in 2 weeks, but I'm just outer limit is August 31st.
We want to practice also for some time at least.
Yeah, no. Our intent is to do it in 2 weeks.
Okay.
CDSL, it would be available in August?
We are trying to make it available, sir. So exact timeline will be informed to clearing members and trading members in the future.
See, the problem is for non-PO clients, we can't generate the link also. They have to do it themselves. There are many clients who have not given POA.
So no, but they can go to Speedy and give that instruction. It is available immediately.
Mm-hmm. We will try to educate. I think that is the issue. It become part of e-pledging also through EDIS will be better. But you are saying in 15 days time likely, so it's fine.
Yeah. Yes.
The problem, Shivkumar, is there for non-POA clients. For POA clients, TM or CM can initiate himself. The major problem is for non-POA clients.
So I requested, they are saying they can go to the website of the DP, of the depository, and then do the pledging.
From website, they cannot do it.
No, they can do it.
Can it be there? Can it be done through website?
Website means the easiest system which is there, and the speedy system may be open.
Sir, I mentioned that easiest is not allowed
why is it not allowed?
Client has given EDIS, so in the trading system we allow client to sell those shares. Now if the client has sold those shares through EDIS and if the easiest facility is available, then client can move those shares to somewhere else. So that is
this practice has to change, because so that if the client is selling, so you will need to move those shares out. So you cannot restrict a client from accessing Speedy.
It cannot be done on real time basis, because in trading system like NSDL and CDSL system has been incorporated where automatic EDIS is approved by the client. So
Mr. Ajay, in case of CDSL EGS, there is a facility available of manual authentication by the DP. Okay, so there are parameters like quantity, value, etc., on the basis of which a DP can categorize a particular EGS client as eligible for manual authentication. So unless the DP manually authenticates the transaction will not go through, even if it is there in the EGS. So that facility can be used by the DP, and then the clients can be enabled on EGS system also.
So similar is the function and also facility on the Speedy. Therefore, if DP wishes to provide a confirmation based on which the transaction will be actually executed, you can do so. So therefore, so that you will have full control in that respect. So therefore, there is no reason to restrict the client from using Speedy.
Like client has sold through a trading system where EDIS has been executed, and second client initiate a e-pledging request. The manual work of the broker would increase, but if it is coming in the month's time, I think it would solve the problem.
No, that's fine. So that is also something that we are working on, but we are just saying that you know, so the problems that we are perceiving in Speedy are not really existing, because so Speedy is also available right away. That's all we are saying. It is not to say that the DMart Gateway or EDIS will not come. So that also is being worked on.
Okay. I think it is just managing for 15 days or so. I think
yes,
it's fine.
Yes. Yeah. Yeah.
So the fifth point is also very important, because whether client can initiate or approve future treasury pledge on T-day itself in favor of trading member and clearing member for the shares which client has purchased on T-day and hit client's remit account on T+2 or T+3 day. It would bring a lot of convenience both at the client level and member level, because at the time of initiating and approving the pledge, the securities are not lying into client's DMAT account. And client wants to do all things. His intention is very clear on T day that whatever he is buying, he wants to pledge on T+2 day. So he wants to do it on T day itself.
As I have explained in my presentation.
That is that is a future-rated transaction. Any future-rated transaction can be entered and approved immediately by the client. So therefore, so it will be recorded and captured in the depository as a future-rated
transaction. There is one complication, because client does not know on which date his shares would hit the his DMAT account. It might go into CUSA account, and it might hit client DMAT account on T+3 day or T+2 day or T+5 day. Level EDIS that client can put a range that the transaction can be executed up to say 10 days. It is not a particular day, it is a range of date. Within that range, the transaction should be executed.
Sir, you have said about the auto pledge. Can it be a client give you instruction of auto pledge, as in when the scripts come into his account, it can be auto pledge? It will ease the life of the client, retail clients.
No, it's auto pledge. What we have explained in auto pledge is confirmation by the broker. So otherwise, of course, the broker will have to also confirm that he would like to accept the pledge.
So I think it has been. Go ahead, Naina.
See, as of now, the facility which is made available is about future-dated pledge, wherein a client can mention the future execution date, a particular execution date, and on that date, the shares will move. So, if a client knows that, see, even if it goes into CUSA account, at the most, within 5 days now, it will either go back to the client account or it will move out.
Yes,
okay, currently this facility is available for future data.
आप मुझे event का ना link दे दो, मैं अपने यहाँ पर groups में circulate कर देता हूँ.
But ma'am, the problem still persists, because the client intention is, if the share comes on T+2 day or 3 day or 4 day, whatever share comes, it should be pledged, because say 50% of the shares hit his DMAT account on T+3 day and 50% of the rest 50% hit on T+4 day. So there should be a range as you have provided in EDIS. That is a very good mechanism that you are providing up to 90 days. If the stock comes, the broker can pick. A similar functionality we want in pledging, because it would bring a lot of convenience for client as well as member.
So we can take that suggestion into consideration while developing margin pledge to EDIS. We'll take that suggestion into consideration, definitely. But currently, with the current system, which is going live on 1st August, future rated execution date is available. We'll take into consideration your suggestion while developing EDIS for margin pledge.
Now, the charges, like, we have not heard anything about the pledge replay charges, because current charges are very high. So, the circular is still pending from depositories.
Yeah. I think if I understood it correctly, last time we spoke to the depository, both the depositories have committed that the charges will remain at 5 rupees total cost. Because as of today, if the shares are transferred, the total cost is 5 rupees.
But so,
the charges are under process, so that you know, after obtaining all the required approvals, we will be notifying in a short while.
Yeah, so it is a request to Mr. Rao and Mr. Vora and to both the depository. You know, as of today, whatever is the cost, and the cost is 5 rupees for a transfer, the same cost should remain after the new system comes into existence.
That is our intent.
Code increase.
We are working towards it.
Yeah. Thank you.
Yeah, this 7th point is also very important. Where the client is a non-POA client, so and he has pledged the shares, and shares are utilized against, say, future on option margin. Now he has sold those shares. So now the broker cannot release if the EDIS instruction is not there against that, because if he release the stocks, then client the shares would go into client's demat account. And client might not give it for paying. So we are suggesting that for pledging in case of non-POA client, if the pledge come EDIS instruction, both can be done simultaneously, and the validity should be either 90 days or validity of unpledging, whichever is higher. Because if the pledge is made, then an EDIS maximum validity in case of CDSL is 90 days, and the pledge is say more than say 90 days, then that even that instruction would get expired. So this pledge cum EDIS instruction with the validity of limited period and validity up to unpledging, whichever is higher. You can see like if this kind of mechanism can be built.
We will take this session and we will work on that, Ajay.
Same.
Yeah, the same as
CDS. Mr. Rao, do you have any suggestion to tackle this issue for us for the time being? How we will ensure the pain of those securities sold by non-POA clients?
No, I didn't get it, because you can still capture the future dated delivery instruction, right?
No, a client is a non-POA client and shares are pledged. He is taking advantage of pledged shares for margins.
No, but how did he pledge to begin with? Because if he is a non-POA client, so it's only through, DMAT gateway, you know, so you
yeah. Through DMAT gateway, either through DMAT gateway or Speedy,
yeah.
He initiated the pledge. He's a willing margin facility for trading in derivatives. At one fine day, he sells the shares. So how we will ensure, how we will protect our interest?
Because I think that will be the risk management system, because system will have to take care, no, before you do it. Because what is pledged is not clearly available with the client till that pledge is released. So how are you giving him the benefit of selling in? So before the sale transaction, that risk management system of the broker will ensure that whether the shares are really available, or then worst case, it will go for an auction on close out.
That is not the concern. The shares are very much available because they are marked as a pledge in this example.
No, pledge. That is what I'm trying to say. Moment it's pledged, it is no longer with the client. Then the beneficial ownership continues the client, but the actual ownership is with the whom he has pledged the shares. It may be with the TM, CM or the CC. So the client has no authority to sell shares which has already been pledged to somebody else.
So to simplify the discussion, assume it is only pledged to TM and TM is now allowing the client to sell.
No, then the TM will have to release the pledge, move it into his, remove the flag of the pledge, and then only the pain can happen.
Right, but the concern here is today intraday the client sells those whatever stock is available. In the evening we release the pledge, but we have no way of ensuring that the securities come back to our pool account.
The future dated instruction, wherein the client can put in that instruction beforehand, and you ensure that client has put in that instruction before you unpledge the securities. That way it can be handled.
Future dated instruction through EDIS.
Can be through any mode, through EDIS also.
Any method. Okay, so you first need to have a delivery instruction already taken before you unpledge.
That is why I suggested for pledge cum, because it would resolve all the issues we are discussing. because we have, the broker has to take EDIS if EDIS so, is not available.
So essentially what all of them are coming to is to build a seamless process flow for this, that when the client sells off securities which are pledged default, if we can have a seamless process flow wherein such securities can move back into the pool account for paying, this is what we are essentially trying to work for.
We'll study this and see as to how it can be made.
Yeah, please, sir. Thank you.
Now the questions are related to exchange compliances.
Oh, just 1 second, Ajay ji. There were a few common questions related to the depository, which I thought I will just take up at the same time. So one question is that, you know, given the fact in this transition, we are all going to time so that as so many securities are moving in and out, can for the month of August, you increase the
pledge is available only within the depository.
No, madam, the security out from the old mechanism into the new mechanism, we might have currently have in NSDL and the client's account might be in CDSL and he has to pledge. So in that case, inter-depository transfer will happen. So if for this duration of transition, if the cutoffs can be increased, it will be helpful to the members.
We will look into this. We can.
Now the queries are related to exchange compliances. Very important for the
few Ajay ji, few small unanswered questions are there.
So we can take it after all the questions are finished.
Okay.
So now, as of now, like if the client shares are lying in USA against debit amount, the same were considered in client margin reporting for all the segments after appropriate haircut. So whether the benefit of USA shares would continue after 31st August in margin collection, or the debit amount against shares lying in USA account would be excluded from the computation of the margin collection.
Hi, this. So. Like worth of security, if member wants to take benefit, member needs to transfer these one lakh worth of security to client account, then subsequently needs to pledge in margin pledge account.
But client has got debit, how the member would transfer into client account if client does not approve for
that? It is as per member policy. I think in handling of client security, we have allowed to member regarding this. And further, 1 lakh worth of security is already paid, right? In your example. So, as per your risk management policy, if you want to take benefit, then you can transfer to client account and subsequently pledge.
Our example is like the debit balance is 2 lakh rupees and shares worth rupees 3 lakh rupees are there.
So, it means, I have gone through your example. It means 1 lakh worth of securities are paid, right?
There is a difference. Let me just explain more. Because there is always a difference between what margin, risk percentage margin broker is charging and exchange is charging. Broker margin of risk percentage is higher than exchange margin. So say exchange is charging 20%, broker might be charging 50%. So he has to hold security as per his risk management policy.
Sir, we understand your risk management policy. If you want to keep higher margin, you can keep it. But the only thing I want to mention here is, as per our discussion with SEBI, after 31st August, shares available in CUSA account cannot be considered for margin purpose. In case if you want to take benefit for margin, then you need to transfer into client BO account and subsequently this needs to be pledged in margin pledge account.
That is our concern, that broker cannot transfer because of the RMS.
Sir, hi, this is Shubhankar from NSE. Here I just want to say that I don't think there should be a problem because anyways the member has the POA.
POA, right.
This can still be used for meeting the settlement obligation. Anyways, in the securities lying in the CUSA account has to be liquidated within 5 days if the payment is not received from the client. So here what member has to do is if the shares are there in the CUSA account and they want to gives benefit of those securities to the clients for margin, they have to transfer it to the
The penalty purpose,
use of POA for the margin obligation may have been eliminated. However, use of POA for the settlement obligation still exists. So even if the member transfers those securities from the CUSA account to the client's account, and if the client is not willing to or is reluctant to place those securities, member always have the option to liquidate those securities, and by use of POA can transfer those securities in the pool.
Appreciate,
but it could spoil the broker client relationship.
Sir, you are right,
but it could spoil the broker client relationship. If you don't pledge it, then I would square off. This would spoil the broker-client relationship.
So I think I will put the question round to you. So I think if the client is reluctant to place those securities in favor of the broker, then even then the relationship will be spoiled.
The problem is the RMS policy of the broker is not allowing that client to be that shares to be released from CUSA to beneficiary account.
Sir,
this is the broker.
Sir, we completely understand. But now I think with the implementation of pledge repledge.
My request is that the exchange should talk to the SEBI.
I completely agree with you. In this regard, we have already had a discussion. In fact, we already have a couple of discussions with SEBI, and obviously the FAQ that has been released by the exchange is obviously the result of those discussions with SEBI. So. If we get any other clarifications due to these representations from the broker associations, then obviously we will, in consultation with SEBI, will reconsider.
Sir, second question. Also, on the similar line, the payout shares received from clearing corporation are generally lie in the pool account on the settlement day and released to the client on T+3 day. As the TM gives collateral benefit to the clients in the trading system, against that those shares payout from T+2 morning itself, and if the client takes any position against that collateral, would that be considered in short margin reporting of all the segment in new system? Like if you see the example that client has purchased shares worth rupees 10 lakh rupees and made the full payment on T day itself, and on T+2 day morning, PM gives him the benefit of the shares after haircut, say 7 lakh rupees, and client has utilized the margin of 5 lakh rupees against in derivative segment. Currently, we consider 7 lakh rupees against margin available with the member for reporting purpose. So, would that be the same scenario in new regime?
So, on T+2 day, once the security, whatever the security purchased by the client, and once it is delivered on T+2 day, same needs to be transferred to client BO account, and for margin benefit, subsequently you need to pledge in favor of trading member.
But client, generally, trading member gives the payout after seeing the is T+2 day margin obligation and pain obligation, and if it is short, then it is transferred to CUSA account. So both points are interlinked, and the payout comes late at 12 o'clock or 1 o'clock, and the benefit needs to be given from morning itself, because the client who has given 10 lakh rupees complete amount on T+2 day in the morning, I cannot deny client that I cannot give you the collateral benefit. It would be highly illogical if I deny client, and once the client use it, I cannot release the shares because he has utilized the
Yes, so we think we understand the difficulty here in T+2 day. Sir, here for this question, we'll just get back to you on this, how to deal with this situation.
Once it is implemented, it would create a lot of havoc and the client would be a real sufferer. broker would implement it, but client would be a real sufferer, and lot of queries would come, and it would spoil the broker-client relationship, and it would be very difficult for the brokers to make interesting clients.
Definitely, so we understand that. But as for the current situation, obviously, until unless the securities are placed or replaced, the benefit cannot be given. But definitely, we need to think on this situation.
Yeah, Ajay, I think what they are saying is they will try and talk to SEBI again, and if SEBI agrees, maybe they will allow it. But as of today, the position is it is not allowed.
So I think so much time is given, so that is a reason. But within 1 month, we have to resolve all the operational issues.
Yeah.
In the similar way, the client has taken position in cash segment, like he has sold the 10 lakh rupees worth of Reliance and purchased SBI on the same day, on T day, and made the early paying of Reliance on T day itself by unpledging of shares. He will get margin exemption on the sold shares only. जो Reliance उसने बेचा उसपे तो margin हट जाएगा, but
right.
But जो उसने purchase किया उसपे margin उसको देना पड़ेगा.
Right.
One more issue. So policy should be framed to encourage early paying to avoid last minute unpledge. Otherwise, वो people to unpledge करने के लिए बोलेगा.
Sir, this is the issue by the major clients. The credit should be for the full value, or maybe after some haircut of the early paying done.
Sir, we have noted your suggestion and we also understand the concern. So, but I just wanted to say, as per our discussion with SEBI, after 31st August, sale value of security can be considered for margin purpose for that particular transaction only. Okay. So we have noted your suggestion. We will again discuss with the regulator if any device.
Sir, there is a similar example in F&O. Currently, you do allow for the purposes of compliance. We are not saying you give us the benefit, but for the purpose of compliance, already in F&O, you do allow this. So the same model can be replicated in cash market.
Yes, sir. Currently.
No. We have noted these concerns which ones are there. So these are, you know, well known to us. We are trying to address. As of now, we don't have a solution. Let me be very upfront to you. We don't have any solution as of now. But we understand the concern, so we will try to work around it in case what is the solution we have.
Right.
So, Dinesh ji, if I sum up it correctly, you have a view that this should be done and you will put it before SEBI favorably.
Sir, I can say at this moment, say we understand there are certain things. So, we will yes, means please don't compel us to, you know,
yeah, say something. Okay, but okay, we'll, no, whatever we think, will be able. That is good enough. What you have said is good enough. Thank you very much. Yeah.
Now, in light of recent NSE FAQ, point number 15, like as of now, the margin shortage penalty is levied by clearing corporation and is passed to the respective client for the shortage on their part. Now, this shortage might be because of intraday margin increase due to market volatility or intraday higher limit utilized by the client.
So let me get your question. So let me answer without you taking trouble to read it for us. So, okay. So the intent behind this thing was that, you know, we should not have a situation that where client is allowed to take a position when nothing has come, right? You don't have a check, you don't have any RTGS, you don't have any check which has bounced. And simply clients are being allowed a position by giving a certain penalty. So the idea behind doing this change was that no position should be allowed when broker is not covered. So this is a very intraday shortage is there. So obviously you can pass on to the clients wherever you have genuine reasons wherein client has gone for shortage. But Having said that, obviously there will be verification of number of such instances, and we will also have to see whether it was a genuine transfer to the penalty to the client. There cannot, like I mentioned, I would like to repeat, because cash market also very soon this penalty is coming into play, that verification will also happen, and maybe you know, we will move towards a system-based verification, considering that funds are also being reported to us. So it has to be, you know, it has to be, the exchange needs to be satisfied that yes, there was a margin collection system in place and clients were not being allowed any kind of, you know, leeway in terms of allowing trade without any iota of margin being taken. So this is the idea behind that. But at the same time, genuine transactions, genuine penalty, obviously that has to be passed on to the clients.
I think that's a very good, I hope I have answered your
queries.
Yeah, no, that's a very good clarification. In fact, your earlier clarification was causing some misgiving and some misunderstanding. So good, you have clarified this.
Next question is for maintain for MTF funded stock. From 1st of September, released to the client's demat account and has to be taken as pledge in client security under case broker would be at risk as only the margin amount would be available with the broker and at risk. Example, I've shown that client has bought shares worth rupees.
Right. We understand. Return for selling the if there is any risk, if there is any debit balance, if client does not confirm OTP, then you can sell it.
Accept the pledge or because the operations are done by the staff. So there might be some staff mistake or some client mistake. There can be some communication gap and position of the client might got squared off because of this. So the broker-client relationship would get spoiled. So if any better mechanism can be built, any alternate mechanism where this kind of scenario does not arise, I think that would be better.
Ajay, you know, what is going to happen perhaps in the month of August when we switch over to the new system, there will be some practical situations, there will be many suggestions coming in place. There is a start, we are making a start. I think a regulator obviously and us are very open to suggestions. So whatever things will be required to do, we will try to handle it out in some manner. I think you would appreciate that all the members would appreciate that, you know, when it comes to genuine technical difficulties, I think nobody is bothered about certain transactions where there is a background, there is a trail, there is a reason. So there, those things will be we'll try to take care as we progress. I think many things we have tried to do that in terms of, you know, certain things to be done on 1st August. Now there is a parallel system. So there 95% of the things have been addressed. So 5% are expected to, we will try to work around them also. But kindly give us some time, some space and some your support. That would be very helpful.
We appreciate that. We brought only those points which we foresee, our member foresee that it would create a problem. So we are highlighting those points only. We know that the cooperation would be there and the exchange and SEBI would understand all the concerns. So this question, I think Brinderji has already asked whether the security lying in POA would be considered for margin collection till 31st August.
New exposure cannot be taken on the basis of POA after 1st August.
No, but can we transfer those securities from POA to our collateral account during the month of August using our POA?
I think SEBI has allowed transfer into the collateral account, so there will be no issue.
So title transfer is allowed?
Title transfer is allowed till 31st August, so there will be no issue.
So then we can transfer those securities, required securities from POA and report the same.
So both mechanisms are there. if you want to pledge, if you want to go into new mechanism, pledge, repledge, you can also do that.
Fine.
Virender ji, you can take up the running question.
Ajay ji, aapke nahi, let him complete. Ek do hi questions bache hain. Ajay ji, pura kar lijiye. Main kar. Uske baad mere paas jo audience se aaye hain, wo do teen questions mere ko zarur lene.
Since client has authority to approve the pledge initiated by the trading member, can TM initiate pledge of security in advance of the trade to facilitate client with the trading limit and hassle-free trading and selling of securities?
Sorry, come again. I didn't get your question.
Since client has the authority to approve the pledge initiated by the trading member, can trading member initiate pledge of security in advance of the trade to facilitate the client with trading member limit and hassle-free trading and selling of securities?
Yes, it can be done. Yes, it is allowed.
For margin purpose, right? Na? Advance of trade means?
Advance so of trade
before selling, before the transaction.
To provide the limits to clients.
You are saying. Yeah, Shubham.
The question is whether that right can be amended to pledge in favor of the current new accounts which are being opened. Can we use that same POA for the purpose of pledging? This is the central point of the question, basically.
No. See, this answer perhaps could be a depository thing, because POA is marked in the depository system. So from our side, there is no restriction to take the securities and in that mechanism. There is no restriction from our side.
No, the point is, as an addendum, can we take this, or we need to take a fresh complete POA? That is the basic central point, because in the past, during exchange inspections also such authorities have been questioned. So from an exchange perspective, if it goes as an addendum to our existing POA, will that pose any challenge? Then we can, depositories are also here, we can hear their view as well.
Very good.
In case there are some certain technical things with regard to POA and how it has to be, then we will have to perhaps give the answer in consultation with depository at a later time. But this answer was purely, I think, from that point of view, that say we are in a situation after 1st of August, you have to kind of, client has to create a pledge, repledge, and whether it can be done without a position, and say some days you want to do in advance. So our answer was to that impact. When the question is with regard to POA and what revise has to be taken, we will have to come back on this in consultation with depository.
Okay, let Ajayji complete this, because depositories are there and this is a common question which I have received from the participants. Maybe you can all try to address it after the questions are complete.
For margin shortage penalty, can be passed on to the client only in case of check bounce, as mentioned in point number 15 of recent FAQ. So what about the if the pledge instruction is bounced of the shares and not approved by the client? The pledge is initiated by the broker, but the pledge instruction is bounced.
So in short, you are saying for upfront margin, pledge instruction is bounced?
Yes.
So I think once the pledge is approved, then only member needs to give exposure. That is the exact meaning of upfront margin. So if the pledge instruction is bounced and still you have allowed for exposure, then there is no upfront margin. Then that penalty you can't pass to client.
Sometimes margin increases intraday, so broker has to collect the fresh margin.
I am repeating. So if for upfront margin, if pledge is created but subsequently it was bounced, so it means it means there is no margin has been not collected upfrontly. So ideally, you cannot pass this penalty to client.
Say in the morning, say client position is margin is 10 lakh
rupees, and in the evening,
the margin becomes 12
lakh rupees. Ajay ji, I think what you are saying is that the margin has increased during the day. So I think Mr. Soni has clarified in genuine cases, the penalty can be passed on. So it is a genuine case. The client is already trading. He has given some margin. The increased margin has not come because the due to some reason the DIS has bounced, isn't it?
Yeah, it can be passed on. I think
Sony clarified that in that case penalty can be collected from the client.
Yes, I agree.
Mahesh ji, is that correct? It is not a case where no margin has been collected. It is a case where margin, client has given margin, the margin got increased during the day due to, let us say, rate increase.
Last two questions you would take up.
Okay, I'll take up. So the second last question was, if a client is having a debit balance of 10 lakhs and shares worth 10 lakhs are lying in his pure account but not pledged, and the client is not willing to, नहीं वो तो tax savvy वाला हो गया ना जी. So let's forget that. What happens if a
यहाँ पर सर मनसुखानी जी ये कहना चाह रहे हैं कि 10 लाख रुपए के शेयर उसके डेबिट हैं और वो 10 लाख रुपए डेबिट क्लियर करने के लिए ब्रोकर अपना इनिशिएट कर रहा है स्क्वायर ऑफ, क्लाइंट कॉन्टेक्टेबल नहीं है या विलिंग नहीं है, तो इन दैट केस भी उसको पेनल्टी लग जाएगी ब्रोकर को.
समझ में why would member be charged a short reporting?
No, one minute, Shubhankar, 1 minute. Can I get the question again, please?
Arora ji, please repeat.
Yeah. If there is a debit balance in the account of the client, and we initiate some scare off, some selling of stocks which are lying in POA, not pledged.
See, we will. I think these questions. I don't know. We will never come into your commercial transaction and your risk management. I think we have never ever come in past, neither we will come in your future, because you also need to cover yourself, right?
That is right.
So you have a debit, whatever assets you have, you have given a reasonable chance to the client to cover those debits. You can prove by trails. You have a agreement. You have been doing it across the board for all the clients, and it's fine enough.
So what we are trying to say is, in such kind of cases, we have to compulsorily do the early paying on the same day to avoid the penalty.
No, that's fine. So what is the question?
The question is like, due to some technical reasons or any delay in process, whether by the clearing corporation or exchanges, we might not be able to do the early paying on the same day.
That's okay, na. That's okay. There can be always situation. Those things will be there, so that's fine. Means you are saying, so you have to pass on the penalty, right? The question is, in such case, how do you pass the penalty? So you will be having proof to all those. Whatever you are saying, obviously, you would have a trail, you would have a proof, you would have a certain things, you would have uploaded a file. There would have been a problem at clearing corporation or your system. So when all those things are there, then please pass on.
Sir, one more point I want to say. The same question we have covered in our FAQ question number 4. So please refer the question number 4. I think there will be no penalty, because the client has sold some security, and subsequently the security was security is transferred to pool account, right? So for that transaction, that security can be considered for margin purpose. Right. Just refer question number 4 of our FAQ.
Okay, fine. I'll come to a couple of audience questions, because they've been pending for quite some time. So the early paying file currently is processed till 3:30 by clearing corporation or till 3 p.m. But in practice, we can only process the securities movement for today's transaction somewhere by 6, 7, 8 p.m. So for the purpose of penalty reporting in cash market, what time will the exchange be taking as a cutoff time in terms of shortfall in margins, cash market?
No, early pain, I think Josefa may want to clarify. Na, they have extended the time till 7 p.m. This was
early pain today also is taken not till 3:30, but around 4:30 to 5. Generally, the time prescribed is 4 o'clock, but the early pain is taken till about 4:35. In the new regime, effective 3rd August, we've already published that we will also be doing an early pain at 7:30 in the evening. So that should take care of the requirements.
And just if you could consider if there are some delays in the previous settlements payout in terms of the timelines, then maybe this time could be extended slightly more.
That is very exceptional situations. Normally the pain does not get delayed beyond, payout does not get delayed beyond 1:15, 1:30. Normally the pain payout happens between 1 to 1:30. So in exceptional circumstances, yes, we will be open. But on an ongoing basis, Virendraji, we also have to understand that. Yes. Sorry. We also have to understand that if the pay, early pain is delayed, that also means delay of the margin files to the market. So there's a, so as far as possible, we like to stick to 7:30, but exceptional situations, we do understand.
Okay. And the second, thank you. Second most common question is one which you were deliberating earlier, you know, what addendum of POA is acceptable or not from a depository perspective, from an exchange compliance perspective?
We will, what we can do now, we will, I think we were perhaps, we will interact with among the MIIs, and this will, we will respond to the association in case it is possible by in a day or two on this particular question. So okay, that you can send it to members.
Correct, correct. If you can all discuss it.
It's little very very sensitive question, and we will have to, given it is, you know, it is flowing from the original SEBI circular on which we don't have any authority to mention it, because the principle stands from there. So we will have to discuss among MIIs, and perhaps, you know, this has question has frankly has not come out till now in any of the conferences, so I regret we are not very much ready for that, but we will come out. I'm sure we can find a solution to that.
Okay. A similar question was that a payout is coming on T+2 day for funds. Supposing client has sold securities on T day and the payout is due on T+2. On T+2 day morning, the funds have technically not been received, but we can account for that as margin for purposes of compliance.
I think this is the same thing with Inderji, which was we have discussed. Like I mentioned, we are in touch amongst the MIIs with other exchanges and also the regulator. Let's see in case we can give some clarification on this, please.
Okay.
It's the same question we discussed earlier. Na? I think T+2. We have sold on T-Day, today we sold Reliance, client bought a SBI, so the rate is going to come, can we use that as a margin? So we are, so as of now, we have allowed for the same trade you can use it, but for other trade, because rate is going to come, as of now, we have not allowed in the FAQs, which is one of the major issue area. We are trying to resolve it. Let's see in case we can find a solution.
The other related question which we have is that given this new pledge, de-pledge cycle, what all reports will be available from the depository system and from the exchanges, both on an end-of-day basis and intraday basis, that what is available, what is not available. In the case of exchanges, this question is also related to, for example, a security could be pledged, but the benefit may not be coming from the exchange because of symbol-wise limits or some such issues. And from the depositories, the question has come basically because we want to know how we will be updating in our system to assess which all clients have moved and so that we can move it to the RMS system. So this question is addressed to both the depositories and the exchange.
So from CC side, sir, I would like to tell that we are giving end of day reports, giving client wise, ISN wise quantity which are eligible for which valuation is given and for which valuation is not given. And intraday on the intraday portal, we are giving the total net value which we are considering at a client level and how much the credit is given. So this information is available intraday also, that we will try and provide end of day also going forward. Additionally, after every release we process, we will be providing a detailed file as to for which client, which pledge sequence number has been released from the CC side. So members can use that for further releasing to the members back office. So these are the additional four things which will be provided by CC starting Monday, sir.
Okay. And from the depository, sir?
So from CDSL standpoint, there are a series of reports. I think it has been, because I'll ask Naina to, or probably we can just send you the list because rather than we reading it out, okay, may not make sense. I think it will be more efficient if we can send it across to you, which you can circulate out as to what all the other reports which we'll be giving. Because by just reading out, even you will not remember, somebody may just miss out. So it's better that if we give you a complete list.
Sir, if I may add, there is a communique number 309, which has been issued on July 16. If you can refer that communique, it contains the list of reports and the formats also.
Right. Shivkumar ji, aapko koi any question you have left for the panelists, because I know it is quite late. We got delayed, and so I don't want to hold back everybody for too long.
Varinder ji, last time also we discussed it with the depositories. See, focus is on OTP. Can we have snorkel kind of OTP, which is available to the user or the client on his or her telephone? Like we are using for HDFC.
So essentially like a QR code based validation, like a Google authenticator. Instead of using OTP, we use that as a second two-factor authentication, because then the person doesn't have to wait for the OTP to come across.
Yeah.
I have one or two quick questions. If client trades for MTF, so the margin requirement is coming in the MG file also. This question is for NSC, that client want to trade for MTF and the same position is coming in MG file also for normal cash market segment for margin reporting. So we would be having margin collaterals and cash deposit in any MTF segment only. So how we would report the same? Because FAQ prohibits us to report anything lying in MTF in the normal capital market segment. May I ask Mr. Soni or Mr. Mahesh to answer this question?
Sir, what I understand, you have taken some position in MTF, right?
Yeah.
So, in MTF, if you have taken some position, then ideally you can consider the fund and security available in MTF ROS or MTF ledger.
Correct.
So what is the issue, like from exchange perspective or from CC perspective, there is no MTF or non-MTF.
Correct.
Okay, so if the requirement is coming in MG13, then the same trade you have already identified for MTF transaction, then you need to report accordingly.
So that means I can report the collateral lying in my MTF ledger against the margin requirement coming in MG13 for capital market segment.
Sir, again, what I'm trying to say, from CC perspective, there is no MTF or non-MTF. Okay, it is in your books. So if there is a requirement, then accordingly, whatever the fund and balances available in non-MTF ledger or MTF ledger, you need to report accordingly.
But FAQ says I cannot report the surplus collateral lying in as the margin requirement.
That is right. That is absolutely right. But the thing is, there is no breakup at CC level. Whatever MTF collateral, whatever MTF transaction, that is bifurcated in your ledger, not in CC ledger or not in CC file.
So if
there is a requirement in CC file, if you have marked that transaction in MTF ledger, then you need to report accordingly.
So, okay, fine. Then I'll maintain this in my database and I'll report the same against the MG13 requirement.
I request now Mr. Shivkumar Goyal ji to give a quick concluding remarks. Mr. Shivkumar Goyal.
I extend warm thanks to Mr. Vikram Kothari, MD and CEO of NSC Clearing, Mr. Nageshwar Rao, Mr. Nehal Vohra, Mr. Dinesh Soni and their team for such detailed presentation and the replies. I will like to say this is a very structural change which is coming where our clients are involved. While 75 to 80% of our clients are maybe tax heavy, but another 20 25% clients are not that tax heavy. We have to see the solution for them also. Few issues where we will be seeking the clarification is how to make the unpledge and paying process smooth. It can be a smooth function for the client. Number two, how can the early paying be increased by giving the 100% credit for the value done early against the shares sold and early paying? Third, can the clients doesn't want day-to-day hassles? In that case, whether he can do a auto pledge type of a situation wherever he agrees, or otherwise he can revoke anytime. We have to come out with few things which are investor friendly. He may not give, because in any case the shares are in the client's name only, and these are getting pledged only, and the utilization of the margin is only for his position, nobody else. So there cannot be any misuse of that. So neither it can be sold, it can be unless it is unpledged. Paying has to be done with that basis. So I think also there is an issue of the shares purchased and fully paid shares on T+2 day, because the payout is delivered to the client in the evening. It cannot be repledged. It cannot be pledged by that time. So how do we deal with that situation on T+2 day margin availability to the client against the share fully purchased? There are some genuine issues of the investors. I'm not saying as a member, I'm saying as an investor, we have to find those answers so that his life is smooth. Maybe there are some teething issues, and we will find the solution based on the practical experience during the month of August. As Mr. Dinesh Soniji has said, I think few of the facilities which both the depositories have said will be brought in. I think they will be brought in and will facilitate a very smooth transfer to the new system. We welcome this change, and we are seeking the implementation in a smooth manner for the investors. Thank you. I again thank you all for a great this session, and I extend a warm thanks to all our members who have participated for this nearly 3 hours now. Thank you.
Will also like to apologize from the members that our original WebEx system, after 9:45, though it was told to us that it can take 1,000 members, but after 9:45 people have logged in, it almost collapsed. And though it, when we came down to around 5:50, we were able to regularize it, it was going normal, but in between our top management of CPI decided to shift it to Zoom. And I am really proud that even 540 people logged in Zoom also. But our apologies, what we will do, we have done the recording of both of these. We will be sending it to all the members. And once again, thanks to all the panelists, and special thanks to our members. That members, we observed that right from Chandigarh to Kochi and from Guwahati to Bhavnagar have logged in. Once again, we will be very shortly coming with the recording of this, and whatever other queries are left. We had online 44 questions. Barinder Mansukhani ji was good enough to get replied 27 of that. But whatever questions are left out, we will be taking these to the authorities again. On Monday, our national executive is also going to have a meeting with the all-time member. So the common causes which are discussed today, that are to be discussed with the regulator, will be discussed with the regulator on the coming Monday and Tuesday. Once again, thanks to everyone, and thanks to Ajayji, especially for getting us the Zoom at the nick of the hour. Thanks, everyone.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. I think it was a lively discussion.
Thank you very much.
but four hundred of our members, those who could not participate because of the various problems, we will try to do something for them also.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, everyone.
Everybody.
Thank you. Thank you.